Well, if everything went perfect at the oil rigs, nothing went right once I got to Galveston. Hey guys, welcome to another Yak and Aggie production. I'm your host, Robert Field. Today I'm at High Island out of Galveston, Texas, and I'm gonna be taking the kayak out about 500 yards out to fish for sharks.
I can do what I want, I'm in complete control. That's what I tell myself. I got a mind of my own, I'll be alright alone. Don't need anybody else. I gave myself a good talking to. Know my being a fool for you. I remember how you make me wanna surrender.
Here about 600 yards off the beach, fishing for sharks. It's probably my fifth time in the ocean in a kayak, and my first time fishing for sharks. And I'm out here alone, and the wind has picked up. It is whipping right now. So basically, everything they tell you not to do, I'm doing right now. I'm after, but at least I got one on the board. So I've been out there for maybe an hour with two baits out. Before long, my reel starts screaming. Now I've caught some pretty big fish, but I could tell this was something else entirely. Fish on. That first fish on is taking some line. I need to get some line back. It's taking out way too much line. The only way I don't want to go, the pass is over there and the current's real strong over there. I don't want to go that way. But unfortunately, I don't think I have much say in the matter. I got a drag and I'm going to work a little bit. Come on. This guy has taken me for a ride. I'm real far from my anchor. It's going to be a pain in the you-know-what. That's what I'm out here for, and I got one. Not so scary out of the water, it's just a big fish. All right, I'm gonna let this guy go. I gotta go find my anchor. Searching for my anchor. I'm not paying attention. The waves are really getting big. The wind's picking up. I'm trying to look for my anchor and I lean too far to one side and just perfect timing, this gigantic wave nails me from the opposite side. I'll tell you what, this is a really stable boat, but as I learned that day, any boat can flip. Thank you. wave hit me at the perfect time. Oh my god. That was my first time ever having to flip the kayak back over. Obviously, the conditions are getting worse. I think I'm just gonna call it a day. I got my first shark. I flipped for the first time. Today was a day of many firsts. Now I can make a video on how not to go shark fishing. I get back to the beach, I'm obviously exhausted. I pull up the kayak. Well, within 5 minutes, these guys come rushing up with these crazy looking walkie talkies asking whose kayak it is. I tell them it's mine, and they said somebody called the Coast Guard on me. Next thing I know, helicopters flying overhead. I learned a lot of things this trip. I learned that sometimes you gotta let Mother Nature win. Sometimes it's not worth pushing the limits. No fish is worth dying for. I'll tell you what, I broke a lot of rules and did a lot of things wrong on this trip. I never should have been out there alone. I shouldn't have been out there in those conditions with people, to be honest. It was an amazing experience and one that I will never forget. That's gonna do it for this three-part series. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I'm glad you came along for the ride. For now, Yak and Aggie out.